How to sell your home in a divorce? We will just discuss this important issue, so don't go away. Hi, this is Sushma. Thank you for tuning in and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to take a peek into some of the things you can do when a house is involved in a divorce proceedings. Going through a divorce is never easy. It can be both emotionally and financially stressful. Even more so if you do have children and property together, it can be incredibly hard to think about selling the home that you shared with your spouse and to decide whether to move in your new home. There are anxieties and stress that one goes through during this process. Try to take a break and give yourself time to fully process these massive changes in your life. When you're ready, it is time to think about the important question related to the selling of the home you formerly shared with your spouse. Here are some of the important questions that needed to be addressed to make it easy for you to sell the home and move on. As a note of caution, this is for a general discussion only and should not be considered as a legal advice. And I'm not a legal expert, simply talking from a real estate agent's perspective. Always consult a legal professional for legal advice. So here we go. First, how do I sell a home with someone I don't get along with anymore? It can be very frustrating when you're trying to sell a home with an uncooperative spouse. There might be a delay in the process by making it difficult for you to finish the needed renovations, being unreasonable with the terms, and the worst is preventing the divorce from proceedings. Sometimes the spouse will intentionally make the house unsellable or have it sold for a much lesser price. If you are being forced to buy out or pressured to sell by your spouse, you can get protection from court. This is a legal arrangement called exclusive possession, where the one spouse is entitled to live in the matrimonial home while the other needs to vacate. During this time, both spouses should prepare the home to be sold in the market. The higher the sale price, the more money each spouse will get after divorce. It is important to remember, though, that you can make major decisions such as renting, subletting, refinancing or selling without your spouse's written permission under the Ontario Family Law, it is highly recommended for you to consult a divorce attorney regarding the sale of the home and preventing obstacles from the spouse. Second question, how do we split the money from the sale? If you and your spouse decide to sell and split the money, then you are both required to share also in the expenses for the renovations and upgrades needed to sell the house in the market. Before selling, make sure that the separation agreement has been finalized, or else the real estate lawyer will hold the proceeds in a trust. Third, what if our home doesn't sell right away? How do we make sure we sell and just get it over with? Do not advertise your home as a divorce sale and let potential buyers know that you're selling because of a divorce. The reason is that these buyers would then think that you are in a rush to sell your home and that they have the upper hand in negotiating the price. Instead, prepare your home very well for the market by staging it as if you and your spouse are still living together. Make it into an appealing and comfortable house that would invite buyers to imagine themselves living in that warm space. Hiring a real estate agent who has experience in dealing with divorce sales will make the process much easier. Fourth, are there pros and cons to selling and what other options are available? The advantage of selling your home is that having a fresh start would be easier without any ties, especially if you are no longer in good terms with your ex-spouse. You can use the money you get from the sale to buy a new property. This can also mean that you have to go through the trouble of finding new school if you have children together. Some couples wait until the children are at a certain age before deciding to sell. Other than selling and splitting the proceeds, the other options available are buy out the spouse and fully own the property. When you buy your spouse share, you will have to take care of the existing mortgage, also pay half of the equity to your spouse, maintain mutual ownerships and turn the home into rented or divide the property and each spouse live in their designated space. This option only works if you both are in good terms and one won't mind making any major decisions together. Both should get a lawyer to finalize a contract that states each one's responsibilities towards the property. And lastly, should I rent or buy again after the divorce is over? Some wonder which is the best course to take after a divorce, rent or buy a property. It's only natural after divorce that you want to have a fresh start and move to a new home. However, there are couples of things to consider first. After divorce, there are typically mortgages and obligations within the marriage that were not cleared up yet. This would likely affect how financial institutions decide on mortgage, terms for down payment for your new home. On the other hand, when you rent, it will give you time to prepare yourself financially and emotionally. Selling a home during or after a divorce is not very different from selling under normal circumstances. However, there are special things to consider. The pros and cons in selling and other options you might want to try. I hope you found this information useful. Thank you again and see you soon.